Welcome back to Balance and Entertainment, the Good Morning Naija Show. I hope so that be enjoyed that special one from Nike Arts Gallery. And she already talk betterment of how art, how she don't take transform art to do better thing. Remember, I say we'll be telling you that the one where we say Oga OVA success for Delta State. Been talk say where they talk say last school na scam. Into say school not fi be scam and school not be scam. Now Nike on her own, not talk say, even though she don't go school, oh, say better things where schools don't they do for her, don't they invite her, so they give her a doctorate degree. It shows a school, no be scam. But please, still hit us up on Twitter, at WhatsApp. Let us know how you take feel concerning that people they talk say school and scam. The thing you read for school, how you don't take benefit you now, the kind of work way they do, or the kind of business way they do. But right now, we guys, go Chukwudi in the building, and he go help us analyze the headlines where they inside papers. Mr. Chukwudi Ezugu.
Mr. Bernard Akede. Happy New Week.
Happy New Week. Even though that Tuesday.
Even though that Tuesday, that's the first time they see this week. So on top of this arrangement.
Yes, so happy will say anytime when you wake up, now your own good morning.
Yes, very true. Very true.
All right, now we go like Chuka inside the papers. The very first one we are hoping for her, now the Vanguard newspaper. Now, on top of the Vanguard newspaper, you go see I'm there. Top left corner, we go start there. Onyagu in Zenith Banks is the Zenith Bank's new GMD CEO for all of now where they use Zenith account. Ndume meets Oshibanjo, says no stepping down. For Lawan, P5 will tell you more about that one. And then Chairman Christian Chukwu to be flown abroad. This one, a sad story, we'll be here. We say Christian Chukwu, we don't seek well. And they talk, say, Nigerian government, don't they neglect our own heroes. Now, more come up for the enter the Guatori for the Vanguard newspaper, you go see, and the insecurity worsens. 14 killed in Katsina. IGP deploys special squad, page 2. You also see the police inspector, 6 others shot dead. 5 injured in Ondo bank robbery. 12 killed as cultists clash in 2 rivers communities. Mopole and other security operatives take over Anambra West. Ambode summons security meeting over kidnap of fire service bosses. And then you go see here, Ebonyi boundary dispute claims infant and 7 others. Page 34, go tell you more. Chukwudi, I would like to start from here first of all. We don't read so many. This one are bad news. Then it is scattered the front page or the Vanguard newspaper concerning security. Now, yesterday I've been reading some of these stories, and the person we've been put the column where I've been reading talks say, severally in 2000, you know, before now, we've been here, say, Oga President Muhammadu Buhari, they get meeting with security chiefs. Now, with all this one, the question the person come to say, does this not show that our security chiefs are incompetent with all this one?
Well, the truth be say, that person, they entitled to their own personal opinion. Mm. Just like myself and every other Nigerian, when they reason this matter, they entitled to our personal opinion. But in the end, the principal of those security operatives, when be President Muhammadu Buhari, now he must take action. If I talk from now to tomorrow about how, for example, aside from the southwest geopolitical zone of Nigeria, where it be like, say, somehow we get relative peace. I say relative peace because even if you check all the rider, when they're under the headline, they also write and say, the Lagos State Governor, Mr. Akinwumi Ambode, he does summon security meeting over the kidnap of Lagos fire boss. That one shows, say, for here too, we dey feel the heat. Yesterday, for inside Ondo State, some bad guys enter inside bank. Then kill people when go use ATM. Then kill some people when they work for the bank. And some police people also injure. So it shows say insecurity, no matter when we say, for the 6 geopolitical zones of Nigeria, for the 36 states of the Federation, we the first time. But the thing they manifest in different forms. We don't reach the level where we say the police, when we say constitutionally, now they get the power to maintain civil law and order. It be like say the matter don't pass them. We don't even send in the army. The last time when I check, at least 28 of the 36 states of the Federation, we get active military participation and presence for the state. We don't reach the level where we say, soldier people, they even there for checkpoints. Checkpoints. What is this thing they tell us? They tell us, say, we need to not be just to rejig. To rejig means to come up some things, put some things, to overhaul our entire security architecture. And this one, you know, sometimes you go begin to wonder. We get President Muhammadu Buhari as President and Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces. Man, we get military experience. In fact, in the build-up to the general election for 2015, they describe him as a generalissimo. Person when we say he's senior general, your favorite general's general. And this is the person when we say preside over the affairs of Nigeria as military head of state from 1983 to 1985. We believe saying get the experience. But if we're faced with all these issues, then you're going to wonder what exactly will they do. If Katsina State, where the president come from, the governor just come out talk, say, hey, The kidnap when they happen for that state, it don't reach alarming levels. We go hear of unknown assailants, we go hear of marauding bandits, we go hear of kidnappers, we go hear of militants, we go hear of cultists, we go hear of unknown gunmen. Different terminology that they don't use, but this one really shows, eh? Those when they run things, they're not sabi waiting that they do. And the earlier we look at the system critically and see how we will take we solve these problems, the better for us. We don't reach the level where we say, like I said, Nigeria has not get stone hearts. Oh, these people die, we don't care. These people die, we don't care. Thank God, say we they protected. So long as we and the immediate members of our family, the matter no affect us. Every other person just be like palm tree. He not supposed to be like that. He took an outcry from Nigerians on social media and also said they lead protest. Go for inside Abuja, where somebody even described one of the governors, where sadly, go there part of the Ninth Assembly as the most useless in the history of Nigeria for the president or the presidency to say, okay, illegal mining activities, may them ban them. Say foreigners, may them come out. We don't talk of how porous our borders day. We don't talk of how under-policed we day. We don't talk about, say, our security people there. They don't get the right equipment. Every year, budget defense, the money they plenty. Budget for defense, the money they plenty. But in the end, it just be like, say, everything a waste of time. Yeah. You do meeting every day. You do meeting every week. You do meeting every month. You do meeting every year. If people don't see the results, everything way they do, now waste.
Deep point there. If people don't see the result of all the meeting way they do, everything now waste. Last waiting we gain on top of the matter. Then we will ask so.
To enjoy more of this, our Ogonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.